Hi, everyone. Aaron here for zollotech. And yesterday, Apple released macOS Big Sur 11.3 Beta 3 to developers. This is available now on all macOS Big Sur supported Macs. If you're using the developer beta, expect the final version a little bit later. This came in at 3.08 gigabytes on my Mac Pro. Let's take a look at the build number and then talk about what's new. So we'll go to the Apple, then go to About This Mac. Under About This Mac, you can see here it says version 11.3 beta, and the build number is 20E5196F. And within this beta, there's a few different changes, similar to what we saw on iOS 14.5 Beta 3 that Apple released yesterday as well. And so the first thing has to do with calendar. If you have a calendar notification set up, there's some new snooze options. So if we slide over our notifications, here's one I set up, and we click on options, we have a bunch of different snooze options. We now have automatic, and there's 5 minutes, 15 minutes, 30 minutes, 1 hour, and until end time. So this is a new option. There's quite a few new ones within here if you have calendar notifications or alarms set. Now the next thing has to do with podcasts. So let's go ahead and open up that. And the first thing is, if we go up to podcasts in the upper left, click on preferences, you'll see this is a little bit different. So the preference pane has changed. There's now only automatic downloads under the general tab. The playback tab hasn't changed, but under advanced, there's a couple new options as well. So we have saved episodes. It says download episodes when saving, and then also episode display, hide played episodes. So these are a couple new options. If we close this, you'll see that we're under the Listen Now tab. They've changed this around a little bit where they've rearranged it, where it says shows you might like first, and then it says recently played below that. So it's slightly different there. Also on the left, under Library, this has been rearranged a little bit as well. So you'll see it says shows, saved, downloads, and latest episodes. Prior to this, it used to say recently updated, shows, episodes, and downloaded. So they've changed that around just a little bit. Now, if we click on an individual episode, so maybe we'll go to Renee Ritchie's podcast. On an individual episode, we now have this option to save the episode. This is similar to what we have with iOS 14.5 Beta 3. If we click on it, it says episode saved, and it's something that's a little bit new. Also, if we click the three dots on the subscribe to or followed episode, we click on this, it now says unfollow. Prior to this, it was actually a little bit different. It used to say unsubscribe, so now it just says unfollow. Also, if we click the three dots next to an individual episode, it says remove downloaded, and it's just changed some of the wording a little bit. So before it used to just say remove and then dot, dot, dot. So that's been changed. Also, this has been rearranged a little bit when you're underneath the individual episode. So they've just changed the overall look of it, and it's slightly different. So there's little tweaks throughout, just like they did on the iOS version as well. So let's go ahead and close out of that and then talk about news. So if we go into the news app, now within news, if we click on help and then click on about newsletters and privacy, and scroll all the way to the bottom, there's mentions of issues in newsletters. So you'll see it says, in some countries, if you subscribe to Apple News Plus, you can choose to include new issues of a magazine you follow in your email newsletter. So this looks like it's something coming in the future. So far, there's no option for it, but it's mentioned here. And thanks to my friend Steve Mosier for helping me find quite a few of these. And another thing he found is the mention within the code of Apple removing Rosetta from Macs during updates. So, for example, what that means is within this update, there's odd text that says Rosetta will be removed upon installing this update. Rosetta is no longer available in your region. So it may be region specific, we're not really sure, but it seems like Rosetta, which is the translator for x86 applications or applications that run on Intel to work on M1, for example, they may not be available in some regions. What this has to do specifically with, we're not sure yet, but it seems like Apple's making a change with it for the future. Now, if we go into system preferences, and there's something we can't see as well that has to do with game controllers. For example, when you connect a game controller, you may have the option to modify your keys to be set up for that game controller as well. So there's images showing this. And as you can see here on the keyboard, there's hints to an R1 assignment on the keyboard. So this would be an Xbox controller where you have X, Y, B, A, the left control stick using the W, A, S, D keys, and then maybe R1 here or Y. So you might have this option to actually assign keys based on controllers in the future. It's nowhere to be found within applications that I can find, but it looks like it will be coming soon. Now, if you have a MacBook and maybe the battery starts to go bad, there's a new message you could see since MacBooks now track battery health. So if you go into your battery health on a MacBook, these are just screenshots from my M1 MacBook Pro. You'll see it says battery condition normal, maximum capacity 100%. However, if the battery gets low in capacity and needs to be physically replaced, it may pop up an option that says the battery isn't functioning normally and requires service. Please check your service options. So it may let you know that you need to change it, and they've changed the wording on it as well. So that's something that if you have a bad battery after years of use, you probably will see. There's one other thing to note about this particular update, and that is support for the developer transition kit is no longer available with beta 3. So if you were a developer and you had the Mac Mini transition kit prior to the M1 Max coming out, that should have been sent back in, and beta 3 will no longer work on it. So that's just something Apple mentioned in the notes. There's also five other resolved issues, or five total resolved issues, that are mostly developer focused, but labels for some controls in a customized toolbar now show as expected in icon and text display mode, for example. So those are all things that have been updated. Now, other than that, that's it for this particular update as far as what's new. I've been using it on my Mac Pro and my MacBook Pro, the M1 MacBook Pro, and looking at what Apple's doing with iOS 14.5 beta 3 and this beta, we probably will have a couple more betas before a final release if Apple continues to do what they normally do. So I would expect a beta next week and maybe the following week with a final release later in March or early April. So based off that information, I think we'll see a final around that time releasing to the public. But at this point, there's not an actual timeline that Apple has given. But performance-wise, it has actually been a little bit slow with beta 2, so I'm hoping it improves. The same is true with battery on the MacBook Pro, and hopefully there's some performance improvements. Final Cut Pro has been very sluggish, and honestly, I probably should not have put it on one of my main production Macs for YouTube. And also when using applications to record audio, I had some issues as well. So there's definitely some issues within beta 3 as well. That's with beta 3 I had issues with audio recording. So hopefully that'll be resolved, and of course I'll report it in feedback. If you'd like to get your hands on this wallpaper, of course, I'll link it in the description like I normally do. And if you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe. And if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.